So, welcome to podcast. Why why Japan? So I'm the host. I'm co-host
here. You're the host. Okay, cool. Host and co-host.
I'm the host, Meshida. I'm a stand-up comedian. Yeah. So and co-host is.
I'm Lai. I think you saw me last time. Hi.
So, Lai-chan, this podcast theme is.
Today we're talking about Deai cafes.
Wow. Many foreign people can understand. So, how can we translate it in English?
Kind of like a place to meet people, except this is usually more like women can enter for free, men pay to enter, and then pay a fee if they leave with a lady.
In Japan, it's like an ordinary system. Yeah. We have many that kind of places, but actually, I didn't know about it because sometimes I saw Deai cafe, Deai kissa, but I didn't know. I always, when I saw it, I felt, oh, it's kind of maybe weird things. Then you told me so about Deai kissa, Deai cafe, and I searched it on YouTube.
Okay.
And nowadays, many Japanese YouTubers, how can it sneak into? Sneaked into their cafe, and then they show what is going on. Usually, women ask them to go to hotel, and then average fee is like it depends on age.
Okay, I didn't know that.
But usually, like 20,000 yen, 2,000 yen.
Really?
Yeah, 2,000 yen to go to hotel. Yeah.
Oh, to leave together, not to enter the cafe.
Enter the cafe maybe it's more cheap, like 2,000 yen, 3,000. I'm not sure. But if they agree to go to hotel, may have to pay 20,000 yen.
Oh wow!
Yeah. But of course, in Japan, if the store provides that kind of places, it's illegal. That's why store just provide cafe, you know? And the men and the women just met by chance, and then they just, you know, maybe fall in love, and then go to the hotel together. That's the system.
Fall in love with his wallet.
Yeah, wallet. Yeah, it's very normal. Usually, adult women like fall in love to men's wallet, you know. That's the reality.
Is that why you're single? So the system, I didn't know the men's side of it.
Yeah.
For women, the one I've been to, mainly I used to go because, like, you enter and then there's sort of like a door on the left and right to this half circle room. And you all sit facing inwards. There's actually another little room in the center. And that little room in the center is where men can sit and see the woman. For a woman, you actually have a one-way mirror. So it's like a window for them, but a mirror for
you. We call it magic mirror.
Oh, okay, magic mirror.
We often see it like a Japanese porn.
You have one of those. And you can get free drinks, so like tea, not alcohol, but free drinks, coffee, tea. And also you can use hair straighteners and hair curlers. So I used to go just to enter, sit down, do my hair before going out with friends, especially if it was raining and you just wanted somewhere to sit down for 20 minutes.
Really?
Yeah, and it's free for women, so you could just go in, do your hair and leave.
Wow.
That's mainly, it doesn't have to be that you go home with someone.
Okay, first of all, you went to there.
Yeah.
You were employee? No,
you don't. You just sort of like, my friend introduced, okay, full disclosure, my friend was a prostitute. She used to, I don't know, I don't talk to her anymore. But at the time, she used to come to the bar I was working at, and she took me. And she used it to find customers, but she just said like, hey, just, you sign up, you put down like your name and details, and you've got a card. And so you just sign in, sit down, and then I just would do my hair and makeup, and then leave.
Ah, okay. So you show your like an ID.
Yeah.
And then you prove like you are like a kind of ordinary people.
So they know who you are, and then they know also if you leave with a man, it means they can keep track of who left with who. And so basically, I don't know how it works for men, but for women, like, the staff would just come to you and say, a guy wants to talk to you. And there's these little private rooms that you move to for 10 minutes just to say hello.
Private room?
Yeah, like a little small.
So how size?
About the size of that sofa you're sitting on.
Oh my God, it's very close.
Yeah, so like, you sit next to them and just sort of say hi, your name, where you're usually, because I'm a foreigner, where are you from?
Yeah, I know.
Do you speak English?
日本語上手ですね。 How did you study Japanese?
Yes, I'm studying English. Please teach me. and so then I'd say, okay, I'll teach you if you pay me 5,000 yen. Expensive 英会話 lessons. It's a
ぼったくり 英会話. Can I say, how can I say in English, ぼったくり?
Yeah, like...
Fake, like fraud, cheating. No, cheating. Frauding. We have a lot of ぼったくり bar, ぼったくり English class, yeah. Okay, so how many times did you go there and then... Met man.
I don't think I ever. I think once. So my friend told me the best way to do it is just say "jōkenwa," which means like, "What are your terms?"
Ah, I saw it on YouTube channel.
The girls will just say like "jōkenwa," and then basically one time someone offered me 5,000 yen to go to karaoke, and I said, "I won't do anything else. If you just want to go and sing, okay." And then he paid me to go sing karaoke with him.
Really?
Yeah.
Pay 5,000 for you to just go to karaoke and then sing weird otaku songs?
You're mean to me, but some guys like me.
No. I mean, I know you're beautiful, like Jack, I understand, but you are otaku. you're like visual kei.
No, because the thing is, they want you to sing English songs. Ah. And you're terrible at them, but you just go like, I'm on the top of the world. Okay, and they're like, oh, your English accent is amazing.
But your score is very low.
Yeah, but they don't look at that. They just hear the English accent and think it's amazing.
Okay, Raisha, believe me, I have never been to Deai Cafe.
Yeah. See, as soon as you said you looked at it and you thought it was some weird thing, I thought you must have gone. Because you always, like, you snuck into a porn video shop.
It's totally different. It's a private video, private room service, you know, by myself, you know.
This one, I mean...
It's, because now I have a roommate.
Okay, so you snuck in apparently not just for the video, is what I'm getting from this.
Yeah. But I have never been to Deai Cafe. That's why you told me, because I asked you. So next podcast, what we should talk? And you said, oh, Deai Cafe. I said, what? And then I searched it. And then, so nowadays I told you, many people go there and they call the boys. Usually, you said like women offer like, oh, how about karaoke? How about dinner? You know,
my friend just said like "jōkenwa," and then waited for the man to say what he wanted.
Yeah, and then all YouTuber pretend to be the beginner. Oh, I don't know this place, but I think all Japanese people do that. I think I don't, even though you go there 100 times. Like, oh, I don't know. This is my first time. Oh, what should I do? And then women. Mm-hmm. I think when I thought maybe 7 or 8 videos. And women always, ask them go to the hotel because it's 20,000 yen. Maybe they don't want to, how can I say, waste their time. Because maybe women knew if they go to dinner, maybe they ask them to go to hotel for free. You know, that's why all women in YouTube video, they offer to go to hotel and to say price.
I mean, I would imagine it's an easy way to find customers. So, like, if you can't just walk up to people on the street, really. So I'd imagine it's an easy way to find customers. So there will be a high number of people who do go. But I also have friends who are hostesses, and it was just like after work, if your hair was messy, we'd go to fix our hair before going to a host club. Or like, I used to go more to Deai bars. Which is slightly
different. What is the difference, like a Deai Cafe, Deai bar?
I don't really know. The place I went to was like, women sit on this side of the room, men sit on that side, and you can drink as much alcohol as you want for free.
Women.
Women can.
Oh my God, women always have a right to free drink. Nomihodai. Men have to pay for it.
The good thing about Japan.
Yeah.
For me, anyway.
Well, you say Japan need women right. You guys have a right to drink for free. That's the most important.
It's one right arm. In New Zealand doesn't even have nomihodai because they would go bankrupt.
I know. Actually, that's why the problem now, many, like before this pandemic, Western people come here and choose Nomihodai course, and then many like people on the TV show, oh my god, they are horrible. They beyond our like image, or like
it's because if I'm paying this much for alcohol, yeah, I need to drink more than that. Otherwise, what's the point? You know,
yeah,
it, once you get used to it, you get used to like just having a few. But yeah, at the beginning, it's like, no, I paid Sanze yen. Mm. I'm gonna drink Yonse yen worth of beer. Like that's the way of thinking.
Okay.
And it gets expensive. So what I used to do was just go to Deai Cafe, have some free drinks.
Mm.
Sorry, Deai bars, have free drinks.
Yeah.
And then go meet my friends.
Okay, but you never met someone, because I know you said, like someone offer you to talk.
No, I...
Okay, you're not so popular.
I mean, like, inside the bar?
Yeah.
So basically men write this little memo saying who they are.
Yeah.
And there's a little bit saying, do you want to talk to me? And you circle yes or no. It's very high schoolish.
And piece of paper.
Yeah, they write a piece of paper and then the staff bring it over to you.
Oh my god, that's kind of like a...
It's kind of like school.
Like a school.
Yeah.
Oh, I like her. So please give this letter to her.
Yes, it's an interesting experience. Well,
big difference, middle-aged man give you the letter.
Yeah. Yes. So if you don't want to talk to them, you can just say no.
Yeah.
But usually, like, I don't mind talking to people when I'm bored.
Uh-huh.
So I'd say yes, and you just move to a separate table and chat.
Mm.
And that's it. And then I wouldn't leave with them. But you'd just sit at the table talking for like an hour and I'd just have a few drinks. And then when they're like, I'm leaving, I'd just be like, okay, well, bye.
But you say like some, once you, I mean like you work in a Deai cafe and you have to move to private room and talk.
So the cafe
yeah.
is more like you go to a private room for 10 minutes, but there's no alcohol in the cafes. And it's just 10 minutes to know, do you want to leave with them or not?
Mm.
The bar is more like, it's still a bar, so you can enjoy drinking together in the bar. And then they don't pay a fee to take you anywhere, but they just pay for your drinks.
Mm.
So it's kind of like a normal bar in that respect.
Yeah. I know. I think bar is more kind of normal, because just like you can go there free. And they may have to pay. And if, you know, ma'am, how can I say, ask you to go out, you may have to pay for your drink.
Yeah.
And you maybe you discuss how much you go to hotel. Yeah.
I mean, I only went to them because of, I don't know how to say it in English, chat. I think it's like scouting.
There are many scouting, yeah.
And so scouts would just be like, hey, you can drink for free. And I was like, okay. And I think having a foreigner there, this was about 4 or 5 years ago, so yeah. I don't know what it's like now, especially with Corona.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I think having a foreigner there meant on the street, they could say to passing men, hey, there's a foreigner here as well. You should come inside. Like, we currently have 6 girls inside. Like, you know.
You're a model, like a showcase.
Yeah, so they wanted me to, I think, come back. Because one time I said, hey, I just want to do some shots and drink. And they actually took me to another bar and made a tab for me. And told the staff, like, she can drink as much as she wants. And I think it's because they wanted me to keep going back because it got them customers. So it's kind of like, it's free for you, but the shop's getting money out of it, which is why it's free
for you. Okay, so you mean like you often went to, not often, but you went to their bar
compared relatively to their cafe. Often.
So for drinking.
Yeah, because I like getting drinks for free before I go out.
But I know, because nowadays, you know, you can save, you know, may think you how much you drink. But before, you know, your boyfriend told me when you drink, so, you know, it's out of control. Yeah. You're crazy. Have you ever hooked up with weird customer or like no? Really? Okay, that's good.
I mean, like, that's also not my type at all. Like, I like host types, and host types don't go to these kind of places. It's all usually middle-aged men who can't
find someone to drink with. Like me, you know.
You'd always be the perfect
always pretend the first time. Oh, this is my first time. I don't know how to do that.
The whole innocent thing. Please, like, you know. I don't really talk to women, so be nice to me. Yeah. It's not the kind of guys who are popular, because they could just go to a club and go home with someone.
Mm.
So it's the people who for whatever reason, choose to pay for company instead of just finding it.
Foreign people can walk there if you can speak Japanese, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, not work. I mean, you're just going to drink. So.
No, I have to say work, you know.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I mean, you're just going to drink. So nowhere I've ever been ever said I couldn't enter because I was a foreigner. But I do speak Japanese to a high enough level.
Yeah.
And also, a lot of these kind of places, it helps if you understand night work. Because, like, when you go, say, go to host clubs as well, a lot of the times there's either hidden charges or there's also, like, things that you expect. You know how, like, we were talking last time, if you go to a bar, it's sort of expected you buy the staff a drink. There's that kind of system stuff that if you don't understand can cause problems. Because suddenly you'll have, like, to pay more than you expected or, you know, you might cause problems for the shop.
Yeah.
So they sort of, I don't know about people who can't understand Japanese to that level. I think they would want you to make sure you understand all the rules and, like, you're not going to cause problems for them.
Yeah, yeah.
Most places I've found, it doesn't seem to be so much a divide between yes to no to foreigners as it is language level. So if you talk, one of the scouts is talking to you and you just say, like, oh, I'm looking for a place that has this, this, and this.
But how about, have you ever seen, like, a foreign man who visited you bar, Deai bar, Deai cafe?
I think for foreigners, if they were going to pay for that, they'd just pay for sex.
Yeah.
I can't That's see a big difference, most you know? People, like, if, except for the experience, I can't see most people wanting to go because you could, especially in Japan, most foreign guys could probably just go to a club and meet a woman.
Because it's kind of, for them, it's a kabakura. It's very easy, you know. Oh, you're a foreigner, amazing. Oh, you know.
Yeah.
Let's have a fuck. Maybe.
I think it's, you would have to particularly want to go. Like, I worked at a supper club, which is where people come drinking off and host and hostesses come drinking off to work. But in my one anyway, they're all different. And we did have a bunch of foreign guys come once. A huge group. They were drinking in Shinjuku.
Oh, okay. Tourists.
And I think so. And I tried to explain that it wasn't the normal sort of place. But they were just like, Nomi Hodai, great, it's fine. So they ended up, I had to keep sort of stopping them going to other tables because they wanted to go talk to all the hostesses. And I had to say, like, no, that's a different customer.
So actually, I have never been there. So you have to extra fee if you want to talk with hostess?
No. Actual hostesses who came there as customers after work. So they were other customers, but these guys were just like, hey, Japanese pretty woman, let's go talk to them. And I had to say, like, that's another table.
Okay.
I think they didn't have that idea that you can't just go talk to other random people.
And you
tables.
Worked there.
Yeah.
To protect hostesses from foreigners.
It was really fun though, because you got to drink with them. And what I found is foreigners often think that shochu is really weak. And we used to play games like Russian roulette with shochu, where one was shochu and the rest of water. And like, I can do drinking games with shochu until morning, but for these people, I made it, all their drinks were like half shochu, half water, and just constant drinking songs and games. And after about 3 hours, they were all really drunk, and were like, I can't do anymore. Like,
and if we use Ichiko, it's very cheap, you know?
Yeah,
Ichiko.
Yeah. You keep the same bottle, but you refill it from the big plastic jugs.
It
was very much, I think they didn't quite get that it was very different to a bar overseas. That's kind of hard. So I think you have to understand sort of the system. And if that's something you're willing to take part in, I suppose. It is a surprise. Also that it's been a long lockdown. I'm forgetting my Japanese. Otoshi. So like, you get brought a little appetizer at the beginning of the meal that's actually added to your bill. So it's instead of a table charge. And like, at first you just think it's free. So then when you see it on your bill, you're like, what? And there is that, like, you have to get used to it. Because if I'm just going somewhere for one beer, and beer is 500 yen, but the table charge is 500 yen,
then it's that's like, a system. That's why, you know, somebody's like, I provide very cheap drink.
Now I just go somewhere else without a table charge on those days.
Yeah, because some botakuri bars, table charge is super expensive. They say, oh, just very cheap, beautiful girl there, please come here. And then table charge is, you know.
It's always good to get all the rules up front. So especially if you're drinking somewhere like Kabukicho, I would always only enter after I usually have like a list of things that like you have to get to the point where you're not embarrassed to check. Mm. Like, so is there a table charge? Is there a cost for this? Mm. If I get you a drink, how much extra is that? Mm. Like, you either have to be willing to just ask or just expect that it'll be really expensive.
Mm.
If you don't ask, you're probably in for a bad surprise at the end when you get the bill. So, I just went to these Deai places just because on the street they just said free. You can drink for free. And I said like completely free and they said yes. And I was kind of like, okay. And I went in to see what it was like and it ended up being completely free. So I was like, okay, I'm coming back.
And then you told me like many women who work in the night industry, they sometimes go to Deai cafe, Deai kissa. Drink coffee or something, take a relax. But on the other hand, they also sometimes work there, you know, pretend to be a normal person. No, I'm not like a prostitute. I mean, like working at the cafe, I come here, and then so you want me to go to hotel, 20,000 yen, it's okay. Yeah.
I would say it's very common, probably. Like, I didn't do it, so I only have experience of using it as a normal cafe for free. But I think people who don't do night work in Japan would probably be too embarrassed to go to
one. Yeah.
It's only going to be people who are like hostesses or prostitutes or that kind of job that I think will enter a Deai cafe. So because I worked at night and my friends were sort of in that field, you go together. But if I tell my normal daytime friends... Oh, I'll be in this Deai cafe waiting for you. They're probably going to be like, oh, what?
Actually, when I heard you say I would do that, I said, what? Are you a slut?
I mean, there is an image and you just have to, but you get the same image in Japan if you go clubbing, I've found. I say, like when I was younger. It's
different from like a Deai cafe, but clubbing is like a kind of, you know, slut or something like that.
Clubbing, everyone thinks means you want a one-night stand. Whereas in New Zealand, clubbing is the normal way we go drinking.
Yeah, I understand because I was surprised when I went to the UK.
Yeah.
And then I went to club. People enjoy dancing. Of course, some people kissing, you know, but in Japan, club means just for fucking, for men. Yeah, I think. Try to fuck.
The best way to go to clubbing we do now in Japan, go with a bunch of friends and you all just dance in a circle.
Yeah, that's what we do.
In Japan, it's really funny because you can see guys sort of trying to dance close to your friends to get their attention, and we're all just in a circle ignoring everyone.
Yeah.
But it's not common here. So when you say, oh yeah, I go clubbing a lot, everyone's like, hey, there's this image.
Yeah. Actually, I think if some people, they have an image, Japanese are shy. If they go to a club, they're surprised. Is this Japanese? Japanese men are so aggressive and dancing, hey girl, something like that.
Yeah.
And when I was young, my strategy, I always went there with my female friends also. Mm-hmm. And then, okay, first, it's like a help each other. Yeah. My female friend, I like that guy. And then I help, you know, sometimes. And then I ask, oh, I like that girl. Maybe you talk to her.
Get some help on those.
Yeah. And I just came here to for fun, you know.
The one downside I have found to that is in Japan, if you hang out like a girl and a guy, everyone thinks you're dating. Like in New Zealand, it's a lot more common. And here, whenever I walk along with a guy, everyone would just be like, hey, are you on a date? And I was like, what? No. It's really common here.
I agree. Yeah.
There's not that. So, on the downside, if you hang out too much with just the opposite gender, people won't approach you because they think you're taken.
Yeah.
And sometimes you have to sort of split up for a bit. Like, you go that way, I'll go this way.
Yeah.
Gosh, I haven't been clubbing in so long now, thanks to Corona.
Yeah. Just Corona? I haven't been there like 4 or 5 years.
Really?
Yeah. Since I became a comedian, always, when I go to the club, they ask my job, you know. I don't want to tell a lie, you know. It is very important, you know, if you want to have a one-night stand. What is your job? I have to show my, you know, I'm rich, you know.
Really?
Yeah, I think that's kind of important things. Yeah, I think so. When it comes to club.
I would have thought with young Japanese people nowadays, probably more people think comedian's a good thing. Because you've got all the YouTuber.
No, you don't know the reality.
YouTuber then.
No, if they see my YouTube, I have just 7,000 subscribers and introduced like a hentai things in Japan. All Japanese people hate me. Oh my god, this guy! This is a hentai! I am a hentai sensei, this, you know. Actually, that's why I stopped because. Yeah, I mean, because I'm disappointed after that. Yeah.
Oh god, I really just want to do a whole YouTube video of you trying to pick up women by saying you do YouTube and just their reaction of like, ah, saw this in there, running away.
Oh, sugoi! English shabetteru!
Yeah, that would be totally it though. Oh, your English is very good.
Yeah,
and it's
So, Rai-chan, so now we are like 32, and then some of our friends already got married. But still, I have some friend, a single friend, you know. And then some people still going clubbing because 32 is a good age because, you know, they get money, you know, like more matured. And then, but to be honest, I graduated from a good university. Most of my friends work in a big company. They have a good salary. So once I went to nightclub with them. And then women, you know, ask, hey, what are you doing? And my friend said, I'm working this company. Really? Wow, how about you? I'm working this company. Wow, amazing. I say, I'm a comedian. I go, what?
Actually,
if you say you're a comedian, but no one know you, it means like a loser. That's why I mean, after that, I told a lie. I'm working this company, you know.
Recently, my friends actually went to, so, you know, Aisekiya?
Yeah, Aisekiya is very popular.
So Aisekiya, in case you don't know, instead of like a cafe, it's more like women usually enter for free, men pay to enter, but you just get seated at the same table and talk to people for a while and then change tables. So you just meet a few different people and that. And my friends went. And, of course, Aisekiya has a much younger crowd, just of, like, they were, like, just guys looking for people to go clubbing with and hang out with. It was in Shibuya, so very young, very trendy. And there were these guys who were, like, 20, 21, maybe 22. And they thought my friends were the same age. And my friends were just saying something like, mada mada wakai kara, like, you're still young. And the guys were like, what do you mean? How old are you? And they said, like, 32. And there was just this awkward silence. And then I think soon the guys changed tables because they were like, whoa, you're like 10 years. They thought they were the same age. Yeah, and then they were like, whoa, 10 years above me. Yep. But, and just.
But don't worry, like over 30 people, because we have Aisekiya, middle-aged Aisekiya, over 30.
I'm not middle-aged yet.
Yeah, but if you go there, you're super young. Yeah. We are super young. Usually like a, you know, 38, 41, you know, and we're 32, really? 32, you're young! Yeah. You can feel young again. That's
The other good thing is, generally I found guys, especially probably now guys over 45, will always pay for you. Whereas younger guys are getting much more into wadikan or 50-50.
Yeah.
So if you go somewhere with older men, they'll always pick up the check at the end of the night, which is always good. But you can also go to Aisekiya. If you're not single, like, I've gone with my friends before, like, I haven't, I keep intending to go, actually. And it's like, it's just a, let's go and meet people and have fun and chat. It's necessarily going to date as such.
I think it's very casual.
Yeah.
I think, I'm not sure now, but before, once, maybe you.
Have you been?
Yeah, because when I was a college student, Aisekiya became very popular. And then I went to the, like, I think 7, 8, 9 times. It's very fun. It's like a gokon, a group date. Hey, guys! And usually went to there with my friend. And then we try to entertain women. Yeah. But usually they refuse to go out. We pay a lot.
I didn't know you'd actually been to one before. Was it, was it worth it? Paying to enter you?
Sometimes, to be honest, sometimes we had a really good time. We went to karaoke, and then one of my friends, I mean, dated with one of the girls, Yeah.
Okay. My friends recently are really into going when they go out drinking, because again, at Aisekia, you can get free drinks as a woman. So before going clubbing, they're like, let's go here, get some free drinks, and then if we meet anyone fun, we can all just go clubbing together, otherwise we'll just go, and it's like a way to get cheap drinks just before going out.
That's good for women.
For women, yes. I'm also starting to realize this video probably makes me look really bad, because I've spent the whole time talking about getting money off men. But in my defense, because I've been to host clubs, I've also paid for company with men.
It's a win-win.
It's more just like, I think, if someone's willing to pay to hang out with you or not. Like, technically, when people pay you for comedy, they're paying to see you speak. I get it for free. This is awesome. But it's that like, you're paying for a service. So if someone wants to pay to sing karaoke with me, I'm like, cool.
I think men, why they don't go to Fuzoku or brothels, go to Aiseki, go to the Deai Cafe, because men want to have a sex with ordinary women, you know, because we recognize as a prostitute, as a professional. And the ordinary women are like a kind of natural woman. There's some middle-aged men want to have a sex with kind of normal women. But, you know, as a result, most of women who go to their cafe are prostitutes. As a result, Japanese men have sex with professional again.
I thought that would have been obvious. I always wondered why guys were willing to pay extra to meet a woman and go to a hotel instead of just going to a brothel. I didn't understand the reasoning behind it, but that makes sense. It just didn't occur to me. Okay, because it's sort of more like she doesn't do it for a job, but because I'm special or something.
She's just nail artist, but she agreed to go to hotel with me. Oh my god, I'm so good, I have sex with normal women, not like a professional.
I always wondered why men would actually go to these places. It made no sense to me. I didn't get it at all.
Because I was excited to know that part. Really? I can do that? But now I realize, oh my god, that's professional, you know.
I think if you're paying someone to go with you to a hotel, they're probably a professional. It's a good way to think of it.
So, and then I think I want to say for foreign men, especially foreign men, if you want to know about like a real Japanese culture, I mean, you want to experience it, you have to study Japanese. Otherwise, you can't understand. You don't know our real culture. So,
There's not many places you can go that provide everything in English.
Yeah. So, and then for women, if you can speak Japanese, and then you can drink for free everywhere.
Free drinks, the best bit about Japan.
Yeah, Japanese women have a right to drink for free. Yeah.
It's kind of like, I think if men go to hostess clubs, from the very beginning, it's very expensive.
Mm.
Whereas going to a host club, usually the first hour is like 1,000 yen for nomi hore. So you can just go to like 5 different host clubs and spend 5 hours having nomi hore, like same age with company. It's a lot cheaper as a woman to go out drinking in Japan.
But be careful, hostess and host have good skills. You know, maybe you're so beautiful, amazing, you drink more, just one more, can you buy me one drink? Okay, of course. And then you pay a lot as a result,
Yes, you have to know what you're doing going into it.
Then usually Japanese women who love hostess, they spend a lot of money there, and then they become prostitutes. That's a cycle, you know.
Also a downside to the host thing.
So anyway, thank you very much for sharing your experience. So, thank you.
Yeah, thank you, and enjoy free drinks.
Yeah, see you soon. Bye-bye.